Hi there, I just hope you're doing well. In today's video, I want to show you some quick tip that I hope will really help you. Thank you so much for coming back to this video. And if you're really new to this channel, I want to ask you to at least subscribe. And then before wasting a lot of time, let's get started. All right, the first thing that I want to show you in this one here is how to get unlimited hotkeys for yourself. Now, if you take a look at these pads here for hotkeys, it only shows us 8. All right, there's an option that can show you like 16 pads in case you don't know that. Let me just show you that quickly. You can just come to the configuration and then you will come to options. Just type here 16. It says 16 pads mod. If you bring it on, you can have a chance to have at least 16 hotkeys here by coming this. If you come up here, that shows the first 8 and then this shows the next 8, making 16. But then you can make more than 16 hotkeys. And Virtual DJ understands these verbs. So what we're going to do here is a quick mapping. Let me just go back to mappings over here. I'm going to expand this so you can see it a bit. Alright, so let's say you're in the mappings area in Virtual DJ here. What Virtual DJ understands here is you be specific in Virtual DJ in your mapping. Let's say you're in the area of Virtual DJ keyboard mapping over here and you want to select a letter that you want to use for your hotkeys. I'm going to start from Q up to as long as I can go. Alright, so Virtual DJ will simply understand you if you specify the hotkey. Let's say hotkey, say hot and underscore, then say Q1. Virtual DJ understands this. And even if you say hotkey 16, you'll be able to set a hotkey for 16. Now, the next thing after 16 is number 17. Or if you say hotkey and then 19, still you'll be able to set a hotkey number 19 on your keyboard and you can be able to go back to it or go ahead to it on your keyboard using this same letter Q. You can go to hotkey 100. This is crazy, but this is what it does. So you can get unlimited hotkeys for this one here. Now, you can only be limited when it comes to deleting this. You might have a difficulty in deleting these cues because already if it's on a pad like this, you can simply right click on it to delete it. Now, how can you go about hotkey 100, which is not showing on the pad here? If you want to delete it, you have to come to either here or on the song that is simply loaded. I would recommend you come here and right click. You'll come to the POI editor. So here your hotkeys will be able to show along these waves here. Let's say you have these hotkeys. Let me just put quick ones like that. It's around there. Let's say this was hotkey number 100 and you want to delete it. It's not showing on your pads. You'll simply come to tap on it here. You'll simply tap on it and then press this delete button. It will ask you if you want to delete it. You'll only say yes. So there you go. You'll be able to delete that hotkey. That is the way you can get unlimited hotkeys on your keyboard. The next thing I want to show you is how to get unlimited horns or jingles or samplers, I should say. I'm sorry to call them horns, but I should call them DJ drops or jingles. Sometimes you could be using custom pads like this one here. Still, they are only 16 by maximum. But then if you're specific, you can set up to 100. There are two ways you can do this. I'm going to go back to Q. I'm going to still try to use that same letter to do that same mapping. It's Q, like I said. Now, I like using sampler. Let's say sampler, play, and then starter. Virtual DJ will understand you if you use one of these two. The first way is you can put one. Or you can put up to 100. That will be able to pick the sampler which is number 100 in your list, in your sampler bank, and then it will play it for you. Even if you have 200 samplers. I'm not sure if the bank can contain over 200, but what I really mean here, the concept is you can specify up to as far as you can in your bank. The next thing you can do here, the second way is to be specific. And anything you put inside a quote should be able to show green. So you'll put a name, a sampler name inside a quote. Let's say it was this, right? You close those quotes. If that was the horn effect, make sure you type the name correctly and then it will be able to play for you Even if it was number 200 in your list, still you will not be limited by any of this. You only simply need to do a mapping for that. But if you don't really type a correct name inside quotes, you might not be able to play that sampler there. So how do you get a correct name over here? All right, so I'm going to close this. Maybe if it was correct, you can save it. The way you can get this correct name here is by coming to the sampler bank. Let's say this one here. Some of them have funny names and they are really pretty long. If you are in this part view here, you might not be able to take a name here, but you're going to pick a correct name over here. So make sure you have it in this list view. So you'll have to right click on it and then you'll go to the sample editor. Somewhere in the sample editor here, it shows the name of the sample. You come to the name. Instead of renaming it, you're going to press Ctrl A on your keyboard to select all that, or Command A on Mac. You'll be able to press Ctrl C to copy it. There you're good to go. You're changing nothing about this sampler, but then you have copied the right name. So when you go back to your mappings, you should be able to paste that name inside quotes here, and then you're good to go. Make sure you paste them inside quotes, just like I was doing over here for the mapping. All right, you'll say sampler play starter, you open a quote, then you paste your correct name inside the quotes. When they're showing green, you close that quote. You'll be able to go as far as you can. You can save some time to do this for your samplers one by one and then get unlimited. The same thing can work for effects. Let's say we are doing mappings for unlimited effect, and this is the last trick I'm showing you for this one here. Let's say I'm using letter Q still, or this time you can use another one. You can say effect, then you open quotes, just like we did for the sampler. You specify, let's say it's echo, you close it, should be able to show green, then say active, effect echo active. You can do the same thing to play even over 50 effects on your keyboard, as long as you know you have 50 effects in your head, or you have enough number of knobs on your keyboard to map. So this way here, you can map to unlimited effects on your keyboard. A bonus tip over here is, I have people complaining like they have their keyboards are full, right? If I'm to count all the knobs I have on the keyboard, I don't think they can reach over 100. They can't. I don't know the figure. You can comment down below and give me the right figure. But then you can't be limited by any of this. The tip I'm going to show you here is, you can start using, instead of using W, the first tip, you can use Ctrl W, do an effect or a sampler. You can use Shift W, that is another mapping. You can use Alt W, that is another thing. You can mix them up, Ctrl Shift W, as long as you can work with it, or Shift Alt W, or you can be crazy and do everything all together. Here you can do a simple mapping that will work if you press all those buttons together. The next thing you can do here is, you can do different mappings that you can be changing. For example, I have a lot of mappings here. I have for vocal effects only, I have for stems, I have for this, I have for DNA. Imagine all these are full on my keyboard and I can't be limited. So if I want to play drums, I can only come and load a mapping for drums here and then play. If I want to play DNA scratches only, I have this mapping full on my keyboard, so I can't be limited by anything like that. So guys, I hope this video will help you and you'll improve in your mixes. If this is something you didn't know, please, I hope it will save you something. I hope you like it. Please give me a thumbs up for this. Also, be sure to leave a comment on this one here in case of any concern. I'll be there to answer you. If you only watched up to this point and you didn't subscribe, please make sure you do that. And if you've been my subscriber since then, please, I'm really, really glad of you. I hope to see you when you open my next video. Peace out.